Hi everybody, it's Brandon. Thanks for joining the channel. Hit the like button, really helps. I want to talk today about pH of my lawn. It hasn't been an issue. Last summer, everything seemed totally fine getting this whole lawn revamped and put down new seed and do everything else. But coming out of spring, I had these spots. These spots were strange. It looked like an animal was possibly lying in them, or some chemicals got spilled. I wasn't entirely sure until I started doing a little bit of research about lawn pH. I do know, because of my soil test, that my lawn is more basic than it needs to be. The lawn is sitting at about almost an 8. So that's not great for grass. My grass is still growing, but there's patches now that don't want to grow yet or come out of dormancy because it can't uptake any of the nutrients or do anything with this soil that is so basic or alkaline. Same thing, I guess. So these spots I have treated. I treated my front lawn and the entire back lawn with, I didn't do elemental sulfur like most people do, because my soil test showed a very high amount of sulfur already in the ground. I had high levels of sulfur and calcium. So I didn't want to put down more sulfur because I'm not 100% sure if the elemental sulfur is going to increase the already high sulfur level. I'd imagine they are nearly the same. I'm not 100% sure because I am not a rocket surgeon. So I ended up using citric acid, the same stuff you would use for baking or making candies or anything like that. I dissolved a pound of citric acid in a inline sprayer, and I sprayed my back lawn and front lawn. I have 1,500 square feet out front and 1,000 square feet out back here. So I used 1 pound to start, and I'm going to use that every 3 weeks or a month until the soil starts kind of making a change. So these spots, in the meanwhile, I might root out and dig up the rest of these all dead plants here. You can see there's some new ones really, really trying to come through, so that's really nice. I might use a rake, or even my power rake, my dethatcher, and pull a lot of that out of there so it can kind of get all the way down to the ground and really breathe. That'd be pretty all right. Everything else is doing good. Looks like I need to sharpen my mower blades again because getting a little bit of brown tips here. There's my cat Luna. Hi, little girl. My one-year-old cat who is... Hi. Hello. She is a large heffalump, a Norwegian forest cat. We thought she was a Maine Coon and gonna be big, but a Norwegian forest cat get even bigger. She's 1 year old and already bigger than my 12-year-old Maine Coon. So yeah, that's what I got today. Ended up pulling each one of my sprinkler heads and cleaning the filters, the little tiny filters in each sprinkler head, because all of them were clogged. I'm the only one in my subdivision that uses the canal water. And because of it, if I'm the only one using the canal water, I'm getting all the silt from all the runoff from the mountains. So each one of these little tiny filters on the bottom of those sprinkler heads were just jam clogged. So I finally have everything purged enough where there's no more silt, but I had to pull every single sprinkler head. I think I have 27 or something. So that's what I've done all day long. I ended up selling the Murray Black mower. I sold the Craftsman mower today and the Still weed trimmer. I'm doing pretty good at motor repair for some reason and really enjoying it. Any comments or questions? You guys have any suggestions? Let me know. Sure, love to hear it. And we will see you all soon. Look at this little chicken. What are you hunting? What are you hunting there? Yeah, get it. Yeah, get it. Bye, guys.